show me something.
Clinical consultant Tom Serafin is with us now, and it was a really interesting hour and a half, back and forth and interruptions. And of course, my first question to you, Tom, is when you look at the vice president, of course, he had to come out more aggressive than the president did last week, and certainly he did that. But did he overdo it? Was he too aggressive? Did the smirking on the side, did that mitigate any points he might have made?
I thought he lost points with that bombasticness about him. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, he needed to present the administration in the lights that prepared the next debate for Obama. Obama lost that debate with Mitt Romney last week, so he had to come a longer distance than the young man did, Mr. Ryan. So it did hurt him, but at the same time, I thought it was a tie, and I thought probably Biden won on radio. I listened to it on radio because I was driving people around, driving the teenagers around last night, but then I also watched the entire debate on television. So when you see it on television, you know, you could see why CNN called it 48-44 for Congressman Ryan, but overall, I thought Vice President Biden did a good job and did what he needed to do for the president.
Let's talk about that, the body language, because I was watching the beginning of it from an event last night, and with the sound down, everyone in the bar was like, what is Biden doing? Why does he have this smile, this look? What is that look? What's the finger pointing? The body language was an issue.
That's right. Tony Schwartz, who was the genius of radio in the old days, taught me this business. Watch it with the sound off. That's when you really get an idea of the character of the two individuals on the screen. With the sound off, you're absolutely correct. It wasn't good for the vice president. But overall, mm-hmm. I mean, he did a good job for the president. Congressman Ryan, you know, they're saying in the spin room, he's not ready for prime time. Too young. He's not strong enough to be vice president or president. He proved he was. Remember, Joe Biden went to Washington when he was 29 years old. He's 70 years old now. This young man is 42. So he proved he could go toe-to-toe with the VP. Mm-hmm. It was a lot of fun, but it certainly sets up the next, you know, round two, you know, two for all. It didn't go that way. It's one now. Now they go into the next round.
And I guess now the question is, do you think the vice president's performance last night and the way he went after Paul Ryan, will that impact what President Obama does? Will that rub off on him, this aggressive style?
Well, I don't think he's going to do it that way. That's not his personality. The president is going to try to rise above it all. The plate has been prepared for the vice president prepared it for the president. But here's the issue that I think that nobody's talked about yet. They will talk about shortly. The first question they asked about Libya and our ambassador that was murdered along with three other Americans, and the vice president said, the intelligence community let us down. The intelligence community had it wrong. Yet everything he said about foreign policy after that was premised on the intelligence community, giving them the good information about Libya, giving them good information about Iran and the nuclear bomb, and what we're doing in the Middle East. So is the intelligence community just wrong about Benghazi, mm-hmm. or is it wrong about everything that's going on?
Which is it?
And that's where the Republicans are going to go after him over the next 3 days. And that's the question, the Achilles heel right now, the October surprise they talk about for the president.
Tom, before we let you go, do you think this will make a difference in poll numbers after this debate last night?
I don't think the poll numbers are going to move at all based on what happened with the VP. But I think it does prepare the president for the next week. And I think Ryan did what he needed to do to prove that he belonged. So no mistakes last night on either side.
Yeah. No,
no
knockout
really
punches.
Right.
Yeah.